I think that coming to NACA totally sets you apart from other people. It shows me that you're willing to spend your time and your money and go the extra mile, and that's definitely something I'm looking for.
In this video, if you have zero experience handling claims, how can you increase your chances for deployment? How can you distinguish yourself from the rest of the pack? Learn how, starting now.
You're watching the Property IA Show.
Hey, it's Matt here with the Property IA Show on Adjuster TV. And for the best tips and tools for getting on the first call list as an independent adjuster, subscribe now. Click on the bell notification so that you'll never miss a video. Now, here's a little truth bomb for you. This business is hard to get into. The reality is that finding good information about how to get started is difficult. It's one of the reasons why I started Adjuster TV in the first place. But just getting licensed and getting some Xactimate training simply is not enough. Those things are literally the easiest things to do, okay? Anybody and everybody can do them. It's all completely pointless if you can't get work. Why bother with all this if you're not going to make a net improvement in your life and your income, right? Seriously. Listen, even veteran adjusters who have paid their dues and who work enough to make this worth it, those adjusters know that there's a slow time of the year and that there are even slow years. And that goes for daily as well as catastrophe. The weather's gonna do its own thing no matter what. But even on the daily side, carriers can and will do corporate reorganizations out of the blue. The economy can affect how they handle field claims and if they use more or fewer IAs. Veteran adjusters know that there are zero guarantees in this business. So one of the biggest things we've learned is that we have to be flexible and adaptable if we want to keep earning what we're used to earning. Make sense? So if hard times can come even to veteran adjusters, how can a new person even hope to find the right path into this world? How can a new person hope to carve out some space for themselves where this can be all worth it? And the truthful answer is that you, even as a new person, have to make yourself known. It means that companies have to know you for more than your resume or your application, which is just data on a page that tells them a little bit about you, but truthfully, not a whole lot, especially considering the low barrier to entry into this job. Remember, license and a little training is all you really need to get on a roster. You need a lot more than that in order to be in a place where your name gets picked to join a team running claims. Far more valuable than your resume, your big long list of licenses, your Xactimate certification, your ride along with your brother's uncle you did 9 months ago. Much more valuable than all that is going to be a face-to-face meeting with the people who assign claims, the people who manage storms, and the people who handpick adjusters they want to be on their team. If you were an IA team manager and your carrier client had a bunch of claims for you, what would you do? Would you have HR just send over a bunch of random but presumably qualified adjusters for you to put on your team? No. You're gonna grab the most qualified people that you know of so that you have the greatest chances of a successful storm. You have a responsibility as an IA team manager to your carrier client to find the best adjusters on your roster and put them in the field. So that's what you're gonna do, and that's what I would do, but what if it's really busy and all the best IAs on your roster are already deployed? And now there's big hail in Denver. If I'm an IA team manager, I'm gonna start digging through my list of newer adjusters, even ones with little to no experience if my company policy allows that. And you know what? I'm gonna start with the ones that I know, that I've met, that I've talked to in person. Because honestly, I'm gonna be the type of manager who goes to conferences like NACA and spends 3 days interviewing the new and veteran adjusters. Adjusters who spend the time and money to network with me and all the firms that attend that conference. So, while I was at NACA, I interviewed Emily from Compass Adjusting about why Compass comes to NACA and her advice for new people. And here's Emily.
My name is Emily Hawkins, and I am the recruiter for Compass Adjusting Services. We were founded in 2005 and based out of Fort Worth, Texas. We handle residential property claims. We do both daily and catastrophe work all over the continental U.S. We're looking for field adjusters who have experience in field adjusting, around 2 years of experience preferably. So I actually get this question a lot. People call into Compass and they're brand new and they're like, what do I need to do to get my foot in the door? And I do have to say sometimes it's a little difficult, especially if you don't have experience. But I something I say is always say yes. Go on that deployment, go on that claim that is a little farther than you want to go, or even if you're a little bit uncomfortable with it, be honest and be like, hey, I need a little help in this area, but I'm willing to do it for you if necessary. Yeah, we have people that go up there, they have their own little RV or they have a little home up there, and they can stay there for as long as they like, handle as many claims as they like. It just, whatever y'all are up to
daily.
Yeah, as daily work, yeah. So this is our third year at NACA, and I really enjoy it. I talk to hundreds and thousands of people all year long, but they're usually just phone interviews, and so whenever I come here, I get to actually meet people face-to-face that I've been talking to all year long, and I get to meet adjusters that I wouldn't typically get to meet. And you know, you really get to see who they are and their personality, and you really get to build this relationship that I like. And so it's not just like, hey, I'm gonna give this claim to Joe Adjuster. I'm giving it to someone that I know that I personally think would do a great job, that would be a great fit for our company. I think that coming to NACA totally sets you apart from other people. It shows me that you're willing to spend your time and your money and go the extra mile, and that's definitely something I'm looking for.
For much more information about NACA, go to NACATADJ.org, and if you've got 2+ years of experience and are looking to diversify your deployment opportunities for CAT or daily, check out compassadjusters.com. And for much more information about crushing it as an independent adjuster, head on over to adjustertv.com. If you got value from this video, you can help us create more videos just like this by subscribing to Adjuster TV right here on YouTube. Wondering what to watch next? There are hundreds more videos right here on the Adjuster TV YouTube channel where you can learn about the independent adjusting industry, if it's right for you, how to get started, and how to crush it as a working IA. And as always, thank you so much for watching the Property IA Show, and have a great storm. Just kidding. Too soon?